Running experiments takes time, money, and effort, and it's also frustratingly inefficient. You have to plan everything up front, and once you start, there's no adjusting based on what you've learned. But what if an algorithm could learn from each experiment, adapt in real time, and guide you straight to the best solution without wasting time and unnecessary tests? Well, that's exactly what Bayesian optimization does. If you've watched some of my previous videos, then you know that there are different design plans for different problems, like fractional, full factorial, box banking, central composite, and so on. It's a lot to remember. And the biggest downside is that once you planned all the experiments, you have to run them all, even if partway through you suspect that some are unnecessary and there's no built-in way to adjust based on what you're learning. But that changes with Bayesian optimization. So what is this Bayesian optimization? Well, it's an iterative process coupled with machine learning. And here's how it works. First, from the list of all the possible experiments, you select a small subset, either randomly or through other sampling methods. Then you perform those experiments and get the results. Afterwards, you use those initial data or those initial results to train a machine learning model that now tries to predict the results for the whole design space. And based on the training, the model will then suggest which experiments to conduct next, depending on whatever your goal is. Very important, you cannot choose any machine learning model, but you need one that is also able to predict its own uncertainty. We see in a second why this is important when we go through this example here. I created this theoretical experiment where the yield of a chemical reaction is a function of temperature. The blue line here represents the ground truth, and we are trying to find the maximum yield here through experiments. It's only a very simple example. Of course, in a real-world scenario, the design would be more complex with more factors, more levels. But I wanted to start small to get a feel for it, because I'm also new to Bayesian optimization. For the Bayesian optimization part, I use the Bybee package in Python. That's not the topic of today's video, but I leave a link in the video description if you want to check it out. Now, based on the region of interest that I defined here from 20 to 100 degrees, the algorithm suggests a few initial experiments. Those have nothing to do with Bayesian optimization yet. You can pick them randomly or you can use more sophisticated sampling methods, but this is not yet the machine learning part. That comes after we ran those initial samples and we trained the machine learning model to predict the yield. And this is shown in this plot. The predictions of the model are illustrated by the orange line, and you can also see the uncertainty of the model around it. So the model tells you that probably the yield changes with increasing temperature like this, but it could also be like this or like this, just somewhere within this area. And I said earlier that uncertainty prediction is very important for Bayesian optimization, and here comes why. We are trying to find the maximum yield. Currently, the model predicts the maximum yield somewhere around here, and that's not bad, but slightly off. And this is where the uncertainty becomes important. Think of it like this. You have been moving to a new city and tried to figure out the best restaurants. You have tried a few and found some that you like. Now you have two options. You could keep coming back to them because you know they won't disappoint. We could call that exploitation. But at the same time, if you never try new places, you might be missing out on even better restaurants, and we can call that exploration. This is the same problem that the machine learning model has when it tries to find the maximum yield. It already knows that the yield will be quite high here, but it also knows that it might be slightly off or that it might only be a local maximum. So instead of only exploiting this area close to the expected maximum, it also explores new areas to decrease its uncertainty. Pretty cool, isn't it? It's probably not a magic wand, but I find Bayesian optimization really fascinating. And even though I'm still in the exploration phase, I can already see how powerful it could be, especially with more complex problems. Let me know if there's anything specific you want me to cover in a future video.